Well, a positive start to the new year for the cancer diagnostics group VolitionRx. They've been granted the CE mark for their first product, the Nu.Q colorectal cancer triage test. With me in the studio now is Chief Executive Cameron Reynolds. Cameron, good to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, Andrew. Very nice to be here.
Clearly a big deal. Just run us through the significance of it, first of all.
Yeah, it is a very big deal for us. We've been developing these tests for 6 years now, and our scientific team for up to a decade before that. And we've CE marked in the last year or two individual parts of the test, but this is the first overall product which we have CE marked, which now allows us to sell in the European countries and some other countries around the world. And it really shifts the company from an R&D company to a product company. And it means we can help people in real life, actual people who are in this current systems, in the healthcare systems in their country, can be using our tests. So it's extremely rewarding time for us, and it's something we're very happy about.
Well, potentially how many people is this opening up you to?
Typically you screen for cancer between 50 and 75. So in Europe, that amounts to about 150 million people in that age group. If you look at North America, that's about 85 million Americans. So it's very, just those two groups alone is a quarter of a billion people just there. And being our tests are very low cost, the CE mark covers us for Europe, but also it covers us for countries in other parts of the world in the private payer market. So potentially it's well beyond just 150 million people in Europe.
Well, worthwhile, just while we've got you in the studio, run us through and remind us how it works.
So the test which we've been developing all along is the frontline test, the test you use first. But as a small company, we've very much decided to go initially to work with the healthcare systems with their current pathway. Pathways just mean how cancer is currently diagnosed. So currently in Europe, the frontline test for colorectal cancer is almost always a fecal test, which you look for blood in your stool. So how it works, how this particular test works is in detecting cancer. The healthcare systems have this system. So rather than starting with overturning the current system, which is a big ask for a small company like ourselves, is to work with the current system while we do the bigger frontline test. So in Europe, yes, you have a frontline fecal testing, which looks for blood in your stool. Now, if you have blood in your stool, it doesn't mean you have cancer. There's a lot of other reasons for blood being in your stool. So about 5 to 7% of people in that age group have blood in their stool, but only 5 to 7% of those actually have cancer. So well over 90% of people who are positive in the fecal test do not have cancer. But under the current system, every one of those goes for colonoscopy, which I'm sure your listeners are very aware is expensive and very uncomfortable, and people don't like having it. So what we're offering the healthcare systems is a way of triaging the people who are positive in that fecal test to see who really does need the colonoscopies the most. Because every healthcare system in Europe that has a national screening program has severe issues with colonoscopy capacity. It's very hard to expand that quickly or easily. So how it is going to work, we think, is when you are positive in the fecal test, you'll then have a blood test to see if you really do need a colonoscopy, which then saves between 20 and 30% of colonoscopies in the system, which is huge, and also means 20 to 30% of people are saved from having to have a colonoscopy, which I think then makes a very good outcome for everybody.
So you must be hugely pleased that you reached the stage. It's a great event.
Yeah, it's a real milestone, and we couldn't be happier. It's been a lot of work, a lot of years working through the technology with our team, who have been absolutely outstanding, working through a brand new field. No one looks for the nucleosomes, which is what we're after in the blood of cancer patients. It's tremendously rewarding to actually be able to help people. It's fantastic.
And of course, last year you moved into your new development facility in Belgium. How's that coming along?
Yes, we haven't quite moved in yet. We purchased it in October. We're doing a full fit out, so it's gone really well. We're in the process now of fitting out the new laboratory. It's about 19,000 square foot, which allows us to really run not only these colorectal trials, but look at a range of other cancers at the same time. Cancers such as pancreatic, where we've had fantastic results. It's a very, very deadly cancer, as you're probably aware, and something where I think we can add a lot of value with a very low cost, cost-effective blood test in pancreatic as well as colorectal. And we're looking to move into lung in large studies as well this year.
But of course, one thing at a time for you.
Yes, one thing at a time. Yeah. Unfortunately, no company has ever really launched a successful blood test in the screening market. None have really taken hold because they have all the issues we discussed with expense or compliance on the other tests. So the ability to launch these blood tests is a massive milestone for us.
Tell me also about your chief operating officer who's taken over at Belgium Volition.
Yeah, we've expanded the team in Belgium and around the world because we're really looking to make sure we have the depth to launch the products, as we say. So if you look at in Belgium, Philippe is taking over operations, and Gatan, who's the current CEO, is really focusing a lot on the new facility, but also on the product launch with our new marketing officer, Louise. So between the team, we're just shifting around to make sure we have a research focus to keep getting better and better products, but also making sure we do justice to the product launch. We're targeting 5 countries initially in Europe. Mm-hmm. Again, there are 28 countries, but small company, you cannot do all of them at the same time. So we're targeting Denmark, where we've had a lot of work in these very large trials. Also Holland, France, Ireland, and Scotland will be our target countries. And each of those markets are potentially tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of patients per year for this more niche product. So it's very exciting. If we can get those in the near term, it'll really help people immediately.
So a critical 6 to 12 months ahead for you. What are you hoping to achieve over that time?
I'd really like to have a successful product launch, which would be one or several countries signed up this year. And we're also looking to pivot a little bit towards Asia to see what the uses for the tests are there, and also rework in larger trials some of the other cancers, as well as the frontline test in colorectal cancer, which would be used by everybody, not just FIT positives. So it's a very exciting year.
A very exciting year, and you've had so much news out. One other thing I wanted to run past you. You've recently teamed up with researchers in Copenhagen as well. Tell me what that's all about.
Yeah, again, something I think has absolutely been fantastic for us this last year. We're trying to get bigger and bigger and more accurate trials because ultimately our products are very cost effective, very easy to use, and have a very, very large need right now. But large trials help you get the best possible tests. So Copenhagen again, the Vido Hospital have been absolutely visionary in the planning of this trial. They're following 30,000 people for 6 years. So you get blood at several times, 3 time points per patient. And that means you can follow someone from being healthy through cancer and through treatment. So we can see how early we could find these cancers. So it's a colorectal trial, but also having 4 mils from each of these blood samples over these 3 time periods allow us to also look at a wide range of other diseases. In that population, there'll be every other type of cancer, every other type of disease. And being Denmark, they have a national healthcare system which records data of up to 124 things per person, data points per person. So it means it's tremendously broad visionary study which will put us in very good stead for the next 5 to 10 years, as well as helping us in the short term with our colorectal products.
Do you know when we might just start hearing some results from this?
Yeah, they're collecting now. They've actually started collecting a few months ago, so we expect the first samples next year. So I'd be looking for the early part of 18 for really the first data in that.
Very good, Cameron. Thanks for coming in. All the very best.
Thank you very much for your time.